Good morning, dear students. I am Aarti Bhaskar, teacher of your ES subject, and welcomes you all to the YouTube channel of LFS Raptinagar. So, children, now tell me what you have studied in your previous sessions. Okay, well, we have studied or we have learned about how to give introduction, likes and dislikes, your hobbies, parts of your body, and that external and internal organs, sense organs, and how to take care of our body. All these topics we have studied in the previous session. Now, in this session, we will start new chapter, and that chapter is chapter number 2. Now, children, tell me, okay, fine. Let me ask you before that, before starting new chapter, let me ask that, where are you staying nowadays? Okay, you are staying at your home, fine. Are you staying alone over there? No. Due to lockdown, and you are not staying alone at your home. You are staying with your grandfather, your grandmother, your father, your mother, sister, brothers, maybe you have cousins. So all the family members together living at one place or same place. So they form a family. Now, so that we all stay in one place with so many family members together and get each other love and care. Okay, those all members form a family. So, we are staying with our family at home. And all these members are called family members. So children, the name of second chapter or today's chapter is Living with Family. Take your book. This is the second chapter, Living with Family. Okay. Now, I am going to read this. Please listen carefully, or you also put fingers where I am reading. Fine. A family consists of parents and their children. What is family? A family, in that family, parents. It is consists of parents and their small children. And all members of a family live together at home. They love and care for one another. And before only I told you that we will discuss about 4 topics. The first topic is family tree. So, let's learn about family tree. And paragraph is given. Okay. So going to read, listen carefully. Family tree. Family tree is a drawing or chart that shows different generation of a family. First generation shows grandparents. Second generation shows parents, uncle and aunts. Third generation shows you your siblings and your cousins. Your mother and your father are your parents. Your brother and sister are your siblings. You know, who is your parent? Your father and your mother. Who is your siblings? Your brother and your sister. And parents of your mother and father are your grandparents. Who is your grandparents? The parents of your own father and mother, they are called your grandparents. The brother of your mother or father. The brother of your mother or father is your uncle. And the sister of your mother and your father is your aunt. And the children of your uncle and aunt are your cousins. So here going to make a family tree. Family tree. So this is the first generation. In the first generation, who are the members? The members are grandfather and grandmother. And this is the first generation. Okay. Now, in the second generation, who are the members? In second generation, your mother, your father, your aunt, and your uncle. This is second generation. Fine? This is second generation. And in third generation, the members are first you, second your brother and sister, and in third your cousins. This is the third generation. So this tree showing generations. Like in the first generation, who are the member? Your grandfather, father and your grandmother. In second generation, your mother, father, uncle and aunt. And the third generation, who comes? Your brother and sister and your cousins. So this is clear to all of you that in the first generation who are the members, second generation who are the members, and third generations the members are. So this is our first topic, today's first topic. Now second topic, let's move to the second topic. And our second topic is Second topic is different types of family. Families are different. They are having different types of families in each house. So there are different type of families, and some families are small while others are large. Small family and large family. Okay, and going to read a family, and this paragraph is given on page number 13. Students, okay, carefully see. A family in which parents have one or two children. A family in that a parents have one or two children is called a small family. Small family means your father, your mother, your sister and your brother. Those who are having brother, then four. Total number of members are four. If four members are there in your family, it is called a small family. And a family in which parents have more than two children, a parents, those who are having three children, four children, so they comes in a large family. Fine. The difference between small family and large family. Small family means four person, father, mother, brother and sister. Okay. And large family means father, mother and more than two children. Either three or five or four. Okay. If more than two are there in your family, with your living with your father and mother, it means they belongs to a large family. A family in which your grandparents, like your grandfather, grandmother, your uncle, your aunt, your cousins, siblings, everyone is living together, they are called a joint family. A family in which grandparents, uncles, aunts and cousins live together is called a joint family. Now understood the difference between small family, large family and joint family. Again going to repeat. Small family, father, mother and two children. Either both are boys and girls or both are boys or both are girls. But total number of members in a small family are four. Large family, father, mother and more than two children, they form a large family. Joint family means in that family your grandparents, means your grandmother, grandfather, your uncle, aunt, cousins, everyone is living together, they form a joint family. Fine. Now turn page, and this different types of family, there are two types, mainly two types of families. Two types, nuclear family and extended family. Nuclear family can be small, all or large. Nuclear family can be small or large. And extended family means, what is extended family? It is a joint family. Clear means A family in which only parents and their children live together. A family in which only parents and children live together is called a nuclear family, and it may be small or large. Fine, this part is clear to all of you. A family in which only parents and children live together is called nuclear family, and it may be small or large. Now, what is extended family? It is also called a joint family. Going to read, a family that consists of members other than nuclear family is called an extended family. It means in extended family, your grandparents, your uncles, aunts and cousins are the members of your family. Okay, if all those members are living together, are staying together in one place, that family is called extended family. Sometimes members of an extended family live at different places. We generally meet them on special occasions such as birthday, festivals and other celebrations. So the main thing is that we will able to know after completing or after reading this paragraph, our main motto is to understand the difference between the nuclear family and extended family, and the types of how many types of families are there and the meaning of these two families. So it is clear there are two types of families, nuclear family and extended family. What is nuclear? The family in which your parents and children living together, they are called nuclear, and this nuclear family may be a small or large. Extended family is also called a joint family. In extended family, your grandparents, you have parents, you have uncle, aunt, cousins. So everyone is living together, they form an extended family. So our second topic is also clear to all of you. Now let's move to the third topic. And third topic is living together. Okay, in a family we are living together, na? Let me read it. I'm going to read, be attentive. All members of a family love and care for one another. Yes, exactly. If we are living in a family, we get love and care from each other, from one person to another person, and they live together in one home as a unit. Okay, all the members are living together in one home and as a unit, as one unit, and different members perform different tasks. Yes, it is very true that everyone, all the members at your home are performing or performs different tasks. Some are very good in cooking, some are very good in drawing, some are very good in cleaning, okay, and some are very good in washing. So all members are very perfect in their task, and one parent look after us. They take care of all our needs. They provide us food, shelter, clothing and education. Fine. Who provides us? Our parents. Our dear parents. Okay. Our grandparents also look after us. Yes, of course. They tell us story how they help you. See, our parents means our father and mother, they provide us food, shelter, clothes, education, everything. They are performing their duties in this way. our grandparents, means grandfather and grandmother, what they are doing for us. They tell story for us. Sometimes they take us to the park. Yes, our uncle and aunts also help us when we need them. And we play with our siblings and cousins. So all the members, all the different members are can perform different tasks. We must help our family members. We must assist our parents in keeping the home clean. We must not litter the home. We must keep our toys and books at proper places. Yes, our duty is to keep our home neat and clean. Keep our things at their places safely. Family members must cooperate with one and appreciate good work. Appreciate the good work done. Yes, of course, if your cousin have done something good, you have to appreciate. Now, this topic also clear that when we are living together, we help each other. We get love and care from each one. Okay, so this topic is also clear. Now, moving to the fourth topic, and this is the last topic of this session, and that is celebrating together. So going to read it. Okay, we celebrate many festivals. Festivals bring joy and happiness. Yes. On festive days, we decorate our house, we wear new clothes, we meet our friends and relatives, we greet one another and exchange gifts and sweets, we prepare and enjoy special food. Festivals are very precious, or in festivals, our parents, our family is very precious for us. Fine, exactly, we celebrate. Okay, in the family, it's festivals. Are there in the family members, we are celebrating that festival with our heart. Okay, full enjoy we are doing. We are making new dishes. Okay, we prepare dishes. We wear new clothes, meet our friends. Okay, so festivals bring joy and happiness. On festive days, what we do, we decorate our houses with the help of our family members. We prepare sweets, okay, many things with the help of our family members. So, dear students, I hope you understood what I have taught in this session. We will meet you in the next coming session. Only this much for today's session. So, take care and stay safe at your home. Thank you.